loves music, and one of the bands that he loves, the guy committed suicide, and my husband is having a hard time dealing with that, and I'm trying to help him realize that sometimes people do that, and I was trying to help him biblically understand that people don't always go to hell or doing things like that, that a lot of times there's mental issues, there's other things that, because I know we've done a lot of lessons in church, Bible study. What's a quick reference in the Bible to help him understand that, to give him a better...
There's only one sin that you cannot be forgiven for.
And that's blasphemy of the Holy Spirit.
And blasphemy of the Holy Spirit is refusing to allow him in your heart when he's calling for you. So, because he says you can blaspheme God to be forgiven, you can blaspheme the Son to be forgiven, but you can't blaspheme the Holy Spirit, because you won't be forgiven here or there. And that is, I've refused his drawing, I've refused his unction, and so because I've refused his unction, then they have said, do saved people commit suicide? Yes, they do. Do unsaved people commit suicide? Where are you going to wind up on the other side of that suicide? Is where were you at before you had, you got so low that you committed suicide? You know, if you're an unsaved person commits suicide, they're not going to make it to heaven. If a saved person commits suicide, I believe they're going to make it to heaven. Years ago, I didn't understand this, but the older I get in, the more I get into it, I do understand is that there is mental issues. Somebody gets that low, they are so low, they're going to commit suicide. It's like, is God going to send somebody to hell because they died of a heart problem, which is a medical issue? Is he going to send somebody to hell because of a lung problem or because of diabetes, especially if they weren't eating right? You know, is he going to send them to hell because of that? Because honestly, if you know you got diabetes and you're still eating sugar like crazy and you're not taking your medicine, are you not committing suicide?
Yeah.
Well, that one I gave you was, I might give you the verse, but yeah, there's only one thing you can't be forgiven of, and so, and that is blessing of the Holy Ghost. So, that right there to me is a mouthful. That kind of covers a lot. Now again, a lot of people may disagree. And I know there's a lot of people that disagree. There's some folks that will argue to the grave that that person is going to hell. But honestly, after all I've been through and seen and done over the years, I honestly cannot say a person that commits suicide automatically goes to hell. And that's Matthew 12:31. That's the quickest thing right there, because when people say, well, they went to hell. The very first time I had to preach for a suicide funeral, I had people while they're walking down the aisle, I had people actually tell me, I don't want to have your job today. And I went, I don't want it today. I said, but somebody's got to do it. God's chosen me today. And they said, yeah, but you got to tell everybody they're burning in hell. And,
that would be hard.
No, I know, but see, there was a guy, this literally happened. This literally happened. I'm not kidding. Billy Slade told me. And Daniel, when he was a deputy, went and picked the man up. Went to the scene of the accident and called EMS, and the guy was dead. But the guy got killed. And the preacher got there, it was a young guy, he got killed. The motorcycle that was on the back of his truck, he hit somebody, the motorcycle came through the back of his truck, back of his Jeep, and broke his neck. And the guy got up, the preacher got up and said, stood right by, it was a graveside, the guy stood right by the coffin and said, because he didn't know where this guy's heart was, okay? He didn't know. So he stands up and goes, I just want y'all to know, talked to all the young people, all y'all young people to listen, said, this guy here is not, and this guy here is burning in hell as we speak.
Oh, my goodness.
That's what he said. He's burning his hell, burning in hell as we speak.
He called him committed suicide?
No, this wasn't even suicide. This was a wreck.
A wreck, perfect.
And he went on and on and on, and the father got up, held his composure. I would not have been to hold my composure. Honestly, I couldn't have. He said, the best thing you can do is turn around and leave. And the guy said, I'm out through. He said, yes, you are. Now turn around and leave. And so the guy left. But I was at one funeral where the preacher got up and just started doing something like that. And I was standing in the back, and Daniel was standing beside me. And Daniel looked over at me, and Daniel said, Daniel's going to take that microphone out of his hand. And that was not proper, and I was not going to do that. And it wasn't about suicide either, but it's the way he handled the whole thing. It was just terrible. It was absolutely terrible. But this young man committed suicide. He hung himself with a chain. And I went to my district overseer, and I said, I've got a problem. He says, what? I said, I've only been pastor a couple of years. I've never had this experience before. I've got to preach for suicide. And I said, I don't know what to do. There's people telling me he's in hell. There's people doing this and that. And I said, I don't know what to do. And he said, are you God? And I said, no, I'm not. He said, aren't you glad? And I said, yes. He said, you don't know where he's at, do you? I said, no. He said, your job is not to preach about him. Your job is to preach to the family comfort. He said, so you go out there and don't talk about that. Just go out there and bring comfort to the family. And so I remember when I preached on Psalm 46 and 10. Okay, be still knowing I'm God. When all this stuff's happening, everything's being shaken. And at the graveside, his mama come up and she hugged me. And she cried, said, thank you for not sending my son to hell today. And I said, that's not my job, period. I said, but I'm not God. And she said, I know. But then she told me the next day, when she was in a coma position, she said, I couldn't believe it. She blew me away because I really didn't know the woman. She said, if you just said my son was burning in hell, I'd walk right in and spit right in your face. And I said, well, maybe you're not going to hear that from me, period. And I preached a bunch of suicides since. And now, especially as I'm doing all this studying, and I don't see anywhere in the Bible where it says, literally where it says, when you commit suicide, you go to hell. And it wasn't even believed until this century. This century is when the people started sending people to hell. It was only in this century that people started sending people to hell to commit suicide. This century. Okay? So, again, I had a man sitting there. He had a heart condition so bad. It was like the doctor said, you got enough time to live to put people 1 foot and put them in the coffin. And he was eating barbecue like it was going out of style. He weren't taking care of his weight, nothing. He did nothing the doctor told him to do. And he's sitting there with his mouth full. I mean, I'm not kidding. It was like, and he said, I believe that guy is going to go to hell. And I said, for what? He said, that weren't godly. He should have done better than that. And I said, well, didn't the doctor tell you to stop eating barbecue? You're going to die a slow death? He said, well. And I said, didn't he tell you to watch your weight? He said, yeah. And I said, didn't he tell you to take better care of your health? Yeah. I said, are you doing it? No. I said, well, aren't you committing suicide? That ended that discussion dead right then. Never did I hear that discussion. Dead, yeah.